Hi everyone and welcome back to another card making video. Today I am showcasing the new Spellbinders card kit for May. It comes packed with wonderful products and just like always, I'm going to unbox it. Let's take a look on what's included and then I'm going to share three cards using different bits and pieces from the kit. Just like every month in the kit, you will find some inspiration, so you get three card ideas along with some instructions at the back. You will also get a bag of sequins in this lovely color and just like always your adhesive, so you will get a roll of double-sided tape, foam tape, as long as 10 white cards and 10 envelopes. Now these are the dies this month. There are 11 dies, 2 of them are the lovely window frames. You will also get 4 butterflies, tiny little flowers and leaves, as well as a sentiment that reads lovely. And here is the stamp set for this month with a lovely mason jar, lots of sentiments, a couple of cards and lots of butterflies. And you can see that the butterflies match the shapes of the dies, so you can use the dies to cut them out and pop them on your project. In the kit you will find many different stickers, but all of them are different quality, so let's take a look at the puffy stickers first. These are quite dimensional, they are teeny tiny, but they match perfectly with all the colors and the designs of the kit. I will use a couple of those on my first card for today. Moving on to the next package of stickers. Now this one is paper stickers, but they are dimensional, so there is foam square in between different layers and hopefully you can pick up the dimension here. These are lovely as focal points, nice and big, and you can combine them with the matching pattern papers from the kit to create instant cards. I will be using one of those for my second card and let's move on to the butterfly stickers. These are again dimensional paper stickers and they are absolutely gorgeous. I will be using one of the butterflies for my third card. The paper is really great quality, it looks as if it is fabric. And let's take a quick look on the pattern paper. This is a 6x6 pad, there are 20 different designs and you get 2 pages of each design. Some of them are specialty papers, so you will find that they have gold foiling on top of them. Also notice that these pages are not double-sided, so you don't have to sacrifice anything when you are using a design. Now let's take a look at the cardstock, 9 different colors, one of them is gold foiled. And now on my favorite part, every month I am always anxious to open up the die cuts. So I'm going to lay them all over my craft mat and you can take a look on what's included. There are hundreds of them, you get 2 of each design. I like to spread them out so I can see exactly what I have and I kind of arrange them in areas, like all the sentiments in one space, all the flowers and leaves on the other, so that I can easily put things together for the top of my cards. And let's start with the first card for today. For this one I'm going for a little scene on top of my card. I'm using my scissors and I'm going to cut out from this green pattern paper a couple of heels. If you have a die you can use that to cut out your heels, but with your scissors you see it works just fine. Now I'm going to place one on top of the other. For the bottom one I'm going with my Nouveau Deluxe glue. So this is going to lay flat on my card base. And then for the next one, I will add some foam squares at the back just to pop it on top so I give some dimension on my little scene. And now that you have your ground down on your card base, you can pick up bits and pieces from the die cuts and create your little scene. I went with trees, with some of the pink clouds, and I also added the bike. Now notice that just because I want to have everything nicely leveled, I am adding some foam square on some of the trees so that they are leveled with the top hill. And for the bike I'm using glue as well as a foam square just to make sure that it's going to be nicely popped. Now this tree is going to be at the background, that's why I used glue at the back so it lays flat. I'm using my scissors to make sure that everything is nicely and tidy all around. And before I go ahead and stick the clouds, I'm going to stamp the sentiment just to make sure that I have enough space there. I'm going to use black ink and just stamp it there. I went with the sentiment from the stamp set that says "Oh happy day," and now I'm going to finish off the little scene by sticking down the clouds. And again for this I went with Novodelux glue so they lay flat. And now I brought in the puffy stickers just because they are tiny. I think the dimensions work real great with my little scene. So I picked a butterfly and a tiny little heart. I am playing a little bit and trying to decide where this is going to go. And you can see that these stickers are quite forgiving. You can peel them off and place them somewhere else until you are happy. And I would go with a dot of glue at the back just to make sure that they are not going to fall on me later on. I'm going to place this panel on top of my card base with foam tape at the back for some dimension, and this is going to complete my first card for today. And here are some close-up photos. For my second card, I'm going with this wonderful pattern paper that has foiling on top. It is full of lovely words, and I'm going to use the die cut with the cut. Now the cat is looking up, and I think that having butterflies flying there is going to be great. You can use the bigger butterflies if you like, it would work great as well. You can stamp butterflies with a stamp set, or you can even use the die cuts included in the kit. Now you can also go with a pink cat, which is dimensional, but just for this card I decided to go with blue. I love the contrast against that beautiful pattern paper. Now just because I want to give my card kind of a ground so that it doesn't float there, I'm going to stick this thin strip of gold cardstock down there, and I'm going to place the card as if she's standing there. Now I'm going to pick up those dimensional stickers, and you can see that they come all together. Plus, they have a sentiment, so it's perfect for my cat. And as I placed this panel on top of my card base, I didn't like the bottom part. So I'm just going to use my scissors and cut it completely off, leaving that gold edge as the bottom of this panel. And to balance it up so that the dimensions work great with my card base, I'm going to chop off a little bit from the right side of this panel. And I like the design much better now. I think it is well balanced. I'm going to use my glue and stick this panel directly on top of my card base. And my second card is ready. And here are some close-up photos. For the third card for today, I'm going to play with the butterflies and the dies. I used the dies to cut out this lovely frame out of white cardstock, and I'm also going to use the other frame die to cut out a window from this gold cardstock. So I have this white panel, this is where I cut out this frame. So now I'm going to use glue at the back of the white frame and stick it on top of the gold one. This way I will end up having gold peeking through that lovely frame. And now I can place on top the other panel, and you see that it fits beautifully. It is going to provide a lovely embellishment for the top of my card, and you can tuck inside pretty much anything. It is the perfect place to add any focal point. This card is going to end up looking really gorgeous and super elegant, and I think it is my favorite from all three of the cards that I made today. Let me know in the comments below which one is your favorite. I also used the die that cuts out the word lovely, and I'm going to cut it out from gold cardstock again, so that this is going to be a part of my sentiment. I'm also going to use the leaves and flowers dies, so that I can cut out bits and pieces to embellish my frame. I'm going to stamp the word hello so that my sentiment reads hello lovely, and I stamped that so that it's going to look nested in between the word lovely. I'm going to stick that down. Now I want to have gold at the back of my frame as well as peeking all around the panel. That's why I'm going to use foam tape at the back and stick that on top of a 4.25 by 5.5 gold cardstock that was included in the kit. And then I will go ahead and work with the flowers and the leaves, and I'm going to create a little cluster on one side of the frame. And you can see I went with blue flowers. I was thinking ahead here. I wanted to use one of the blue butterflies as my focal point, and I didn't want to add too many colors on my card. I have this rule on my head that when I use too many colors, the card may look super happy, but it doesn't look elegant. And since I was going for a very elegant look, I decided to keep the colors to minimal. That's why I'm using blue flowers and I combined that with the blue butterflies. And here are some close-up photos on the third card for today. Spellbinder card kits never disappoint, they are always packed with wonderful goodies. I hope that you had fun and that you got inspired as I was playing with the May card kit. Thank you all so much for watching and I'll see you all next time.